In this video, I'll be talking about greatest common divisor. So before I write the definition for greatest common divisor, or in short, we can write GCD, let us see some fact for the common divisor. We defined a common divisor for two integers. So let us consider A and B be two arbitrary integers, and let us consider an integer D, which is said to be the common divisor of A and B if D divides A and D divides B. So if D divides both the integers, we will call this as a common divisor. And as 1 is a divisor of every integer, so we can say that set of positive divisors is always non-empty. So this is non-empty. So we can say that set of positive divisor is non-empty. And if A equal to B equal to 0, then every integer serve as a common divisor of A and B. In fact, we can say that set of positive divisors in this particular case, when both the integers are equal to 0, it is infinite. So now if we consider that A is not equal to 0 or B is not equal to 0, in that case, set of positive divisor is going to be finite. So here I write set of positive divisor is finite. And as the set is finite, so we can find the greatest common divisor in that set. So now we are ready to define the definition of the greatest common divisor. It says let A and B be given integers and with at least one of them is not equal to 0. The greatest common divisor of A and B denoted by GCD of A and B, or we can simply write down into the parenthesis AB, is a positive integer D. So greatest common divisor is a positive integer D which satisfies these two property. Since it has to be greatest common, so it is common, so it divides the both the integer, and also it is greatest. So for any other divisor, say we consider C divide A and C divide B, then C must always be less than or equal to D. So and if the D satisfies these two conditions, then we consider that D is the greatest common divisor of A and B. We now consider some example. Let us say we want to write down the greatest common divisor of minus 12 and 30. And to write down the greatest common divisor, I first need to know what are the divisors of these numbers. So let us only write down the positive divisors here. So when I write the positive divisors for 12, this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 6 and 12. And for 30, the positive divisors are 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 10, 15 and 30. And you can see that among the positive divisor, the common divisor which is the greatest is 6. So we can simply say that the GCD of minus 12 and 30 is 6, because this is the highest common divisor. There are other common divisors also, as we can see that 1, 2, 3 is appearing here also, 1, 2, 3 is appearing here also, and 6 is also in the common. So if I want to write down the common divisor, this is 1, 2, 3 and 6. These are the common divisors, and among this was the highest or this was the greatest, so it becomes a GCD. In the another example, we can see that if I want to write the GCD of 8 and 17, you can see that greatest common divisor is 1. And in similarly, one more example, I can consider greatest common divisor of minus 5 and 5. So here you can see that greatest common divisor is 5. And we note that it is always possible to write the greatest common divisor as linear combination of the integers. So for in this case, suppose we write GCD of minus 12 and 30, which is written as 6. So I want to write as a linear combination of minus 12 and 30. These are the two integers. So I can multiply 30 by 1 and by 2. So you can see that this satisfies the equation. So it is possible to find out these two integers that I have written here, 2 and 1. So now I'll write down a theorem which explains this result. So the theorem says given integers A and B, and not both of them are 0, so that we can find the greatest common divisor. So we write not of both of which are 0. So in that case, there exist integers X and Y such that we can write greatest common divisor of the integers A and B as a linear combination AX plus BY. So now to prove this theorem, I will consider a set. So considering the set of all positive linear combination of A and B, we have S is equal to AU plus BV such that AU plus B times V is greater than 0, and U and V belongs to integer. So we say that this set S is non-empty. So this is what we first need to notice down. So we write down here noting that S is non-empty. And to prove that this is non-empty, we can simply consider that, as we have said, not both of which are 0. So let us consider that if A is not equal to 0, so we can write this integer absolute value of mod A equal to A times U plus B into 0, and this belong to S. So initially, if A is equal to minus 1, then we can consider U also equal to minus 1. If A is equal to plus 1, then we can consider U is equal to 1. So for this choice of A, whenever this is non-negative and depending upon whether it is minus 1 or plus 1, we can select the corresponding value for U, and hence we can say that absolute value of A belong to the set S. This satisfies the given condition, and we can say that the set is non-empty. Now, as the set S is non-empty and by well ordering principle, we can say that S must contain a smallest element. And let me to call that smallest element as D. So when I call the smallest element as D, and since we are saying that D belongs to S, it is the smallest element in the set D. So D must be of the form some AX plus BY, and this X comma Y belongs to integer. So this is the representation of D by the selection of the D, as D is the smallest element which belong to this. And what we claim is, we want to claim that D is the GCD of A and B. So if we can show that D is the GCD of A and B, we have already shown that D can be written as a linear combination. And if we can show that D is GCD of A comma B, that proves our result. So now, as I want to show that D is GCD of A and B, and to show that, I first need to show that D is a common divisor, and for any other divisor, this is the largest one. So I'm using a division algorithm. And in that division algorithm, we can always obtain the integer Q and R. So let us write down, obtain integers Q and R such that we can write down that whenever A is divisible by D, so it is written as QD plus R, and since we are dividing A by D, so the remainder have this condition that it is strictly less than D. We have already considered D to be a positive, so we know that D belong to S and S is a set of positive integer. So D is already a positive integer, so we can see that. So here we do not need to put an absolute value while applying the division algorithm. Now, A is equal to QD plus R, so this implies this is same as R is equal to A minus Q times D, and this is same as A minus Q times. For D, we already have this expression AX plus BY. Substitute this here, so this is AX plus BY, and that becomes A into 1 minus Q times X plus B into minus QY. Now, noticing that this is A times something and B times something. So, if you assume that it is X dash and this is Y dash. So, what is happening is that we are writing R as A into X dash plus B into Y dash. And here we are saying that R is greater than or equal to 0. So, if R is strictly positive, in that case, this implies R belong to the set S because of the representation it have. But this will contradict the choice of D because we have selected D as the smallest element. So this contradicts choice of D. And we said that R is strictly less than D. So considering this situation in mind, that if R is a strictly positive and it is less than D, this will always contradict this choice. So this implies the only choice we have, this implies R must be equal to 0. So if R is equal to 0, so our initial selection that A is equal to Q into D plus D, so that means we have A is equal to Q times D. So this implies D divides A. And in the similar reasoning, we can show that. So with similar reasoning, we get D divides B. So that shows that D is a common divisor of A and B. So this is a common divisor of A and B. Now, as this is a common divisor of A and B, so now the first condition of the GCD definition is satisfied. And I now only want to show that if there exists any other divisor, then D is the largest among all. So now let us choose that. Now, if C is any arbitrary divisor of A and B, then C must divide their linear combination. We have already done this in the basic properties, that whenever C divides A and C divide B, C must divide AX plus BY, and this implies C divides D because we have already used D same as AX plus BY. And so to prove this theorem, I must would have considered this as positive divisor. So kindly correct this. This is a positive divisor and D is also positive divisor. So this means C is a positive, so C is same as absolute value of this. This is always less than or equal to absolute value of D, which is equal to D. So hence we can say that D is the GCD of A and B, and this satisfies both the condition that for any arbitrary divisor, this is the largest among all. As a consequences of the above theorem, now I can immediately get this corollary as that if a and b are given integers, not both zero, then the set T, which is ax plus by and x and y are integers, this is precisely the set of all multiples of D. And to explain this, let me to first consider an example. Suppose that we consider two integers, a is equal to 6 and I consider b is equal to 15. And then we consider a set T, and let us write down this as a linear combination of the two integers that we have selected, a and b. So in this case, let us take combination 6 into minus 2 plus 15 into 1. And then let's take another combination 6 into minus 1 plus 15 into 1. Let's take another combination 6 into 1 plus 15 into 0 and so on. So you can take different combination, and if we notice that this is same as this value is 3, 9, 6 and so on. And if I see that what is the GCD of 6 and 15, so you can see that greatest common divisor of 6 and 15 is 3, because 6 has positive divisors as 1, 2, 3, 6. And 15 have the positive divisors as 1, 3, 5 and 15. Note that we have put it a more generalized condition. We have simply written these are all multiples of D. So even the negative multiples are included in this set. We have not included that AX plus BY is strictly positive. But if you include that AX plus BY is strictly positive, as we have defined in the statement of the previous theorem, in that case, here we can see that D act as the smallest element. If not, if this condition is left, if this condition is not included, then we can consider even the negative multiples of the greatest common divisor. Now let us do the proof of this corollary. And as we are saying that D is a GCD of A and B, so obviously D divides A and D divides B. And simple by the property of the divisibilities, we can say that D divide AX plus BY for all integers X and Y which belong to Z. So this means that means every member of T is a multiple of D. So because in the T set we have already considered an element of this type, AX plus BY. So every element of T, that is AX plus BY, is a multiple of D. Or I can see that from here, that whenever you want to write this expression, this is same as AX plus BY is same as D times some integer, let me to call that integer as W. So this statement is same as every member of T is a multiple of D. And this is what we wanted to prove, that T is precisely the set of all multiples of D. And we can also see that conversely, whenever we write D as some linear combination of this integers A and B, so that is AX0 plus BY0, for some suitable value of x naught and y naught which belong to integers, so we can consider multiple of D. So let us consider this as a times n x naught plus b times n y naught. Again, this is a linear combination, so this is same as a x dash plus b y dash, where I have written x dash as n into x naught and y dash as n into y naught. So you can see that n d is again written in the linear combination of a and b. So that means now you can see that ND is a linear combination of A and B. And hence that proves our corollary for the general statement. And this lies in the set T.